Hi, welcome to this video. We are going to see how to use Cyberlink PowerDirector 13 in a few and easy steps. Check out our quick index in video description if you need help in specific features. Don't forget to leave us comments to improve our videos. First of all, PowerDirector 13 is a software used to make videos and slideshows. When you open it, a dialog window appears. On the left, you choose the aspect ratio of the video you are going to work on. On the right, you have all the three main workspaces of the software. Full Feature Editor is used to create full personalized videos, where you have control of any single file and effects associated. The other two below are guided instead. Easy Editor makes a video using files you browse and putting them together using a ready-made template you can choose. Slideshow Creator is guided as well and works in the same way, with the difference that you can work with images only, using different slideshow templates. In case you want more templates, be sure to check out Director's own site. We will see in this video the full feature editor only. If you know how to use it, you will create any favorite video you have in mind. Let's see how the workspace is composed. On the left, you have all that the software can offer inside windows called rooms. From effects to text and transitions, all is listed here. On the right, you have the preview that shows how your video is going on. At the bottom, the main timeline, where you will work to make your video project. Then you have different quick buttons that we are going to see in the future. First of all, it's important to point out that this is not your only workspace available. This is the edit workspace, used to create and edit your video. On top of the rooms, you have the other workspaces. Use Capture to import files from cameras or microphones. Edit to create and improve your video. Produce to render and export your video file, and then create a disk to burn it into a CD or DVD. Let's see how to start. All rooms are listed in icons on the left, and each one lists its kind of content, depending on the kind of room. Media Room collects all files imported in your project. You can add more dragging any file from your computer onto the software. You will find it inside the Media Room, ready to be imported in the timeline. You can also use the Import Media button to add files inside. Just once files are inside the Media Room, you can drag them in the timeline from it. Don't forget to check them first, selecting them and then checking the preview on the right. We will see all other rooms in further videos in this guide. To start creating your video, you must know how to use the timeline. The timeline is composed by several rows called tracks. These can contain pictures, videos, text and audio files, depending on the kind of the track. So video tracks can contain images, videos and text, and are represented on the right by a blue frame icon. Audio tracks can contain any audio file and are indicated through a loudspeaker icon. There are also defect tracks that are used to manage any effect put inside your project, indicated by a white FX icon on the left. Watch the effects tutorial in this guide to know more about these. There are other tracks, like the title, the voice or the subtitle track, listed below or hidden. You can forget about these, since with video and audio tracks you can work without any problem. To add files to your project, just drag them to the right track from the media room. You must remember that the order of the tracks is very important. While audio tracks are always played together, image, text and video files can get overlapped on the preview. It is shown above the clip that stays on a lower track. So if you want to show text on a video, remember to place it on a lower track. To know how to apply and manage text in PowerDirector, check the video related. You can also change the track's order. Just select a track and pull it up or down. Keep in mind that video and audio tracks do move always in couples, since video files inside can include audio parts as well. Tracks are very easy to use. Drag the right side to show name and eventually rename it. You can check or uncheck the rectangle to turn on and off a track. A track turned off never shows its content, which means that video and images become fully transparent, while audio will have no volume. Use the lock icon instead to block the track, so that any file inside can't be moved or changed. If you lock a video or an audio track only, you can unlink audio from its related video, and both of them become independent. To add new tracks, simply click on the third icon above. Let's see how to edit files imported. These are usually called clips, showing their file names on themselves. PowerDirector shows a small preview inside the clip as well, so frames for a video, the image itself for photos, and the complete waveform for audio files. To check them better, you can zoom in the timeline or enlarge the tracks dragging their edges. You can zoom in out the timeline, dragging on the time above, when a blue clock icon appears instead of your pointer. The zoom is applied, taking the playhead as reference. Another important element is the playhead, indicated by a white down arrow and a very thin red line. The preview does show what is under such playhead, so you can check your project in progress by placing the playhead, clicking on the time above, or simply dragging the playhead itself, useful especially in transitions. You can select a clip clicking on it. This will be highlighted in blue. You can select more files by holding Ctrl down. Files selected will be treated in the same way. The preview has two modes. Select Clip Mode to play just the clip selected. Select Movie Node to check how your overall project is going on. You can also take snapshots using the photo icon more at the bottom, and enable full screen double-clicking inside the preview. Remember to use Escape key to exit. The clip mode of the preview can be used to edit clips. You can drag inside to move the clip. You can scale using the white rounded nodes. You can distort and skew using the squared blue nodes in the corners. You can also rotate by dragging from the blue circumference on the center. In the timeline, drag the clip to move it through its track or in another track. Hover its edges and drag to stretch the clip. It is okay if it is an image or text, but in case of audio and videos that do have an ending, you can't stretch over it. In this case, you can trim the clip, which means reducing its playing speed to make it last longer. To do this, just drag the edges of the clip while holding Ctrl down. You can also increase the playing speed. Just shorten the clip while holding Ctrl down. In both cases, a small orange eye in a corner reminds you that there is this effect applied. Let's see other basic important operations. You can right-click on a clip to cut, copy, paste, or delete it. Use Ctrl and Z to undo any mistaken action. You can set the opacity or gain level of clips very fast. When you select either images or video clips, a thin green line appears on it. This sets the transparency level of the clip. The more it is down, the more transparency is applied, and so it can be seen all that is behind it. In audio clips, you can adjust the gain level, so the output volume. On the extreme left, you can drag a point up and down to set the overall gain. You can also drag the line in other points to personalize it as you like. Watch the effects tutorial if you want to know how to apply envelope lines. You can split a clip easily, selecting it and clicking on the split button above. There are many other tools, adding effects, text, and transitions, for example. Check out our guide if you want to discover them more in detail. The last step is to save and render your project. To save, just go to Save Project at the very top. Saving means saving your video project as it is, so that you can edit it later in PowerDirector. These have a .pds file format. Saving doesn't mean to obtain your final video. You must render it. Just click on Produce tab next to Edit. You have four ways to export your project. Standard 2D makes a video in your computer. 3D renders a video in 3D, if you have used 3D clips. Device exports for phones and consoles, whereas online exports on internet sites, matching the best settings. Actually, the standard 2D and the 3D ones give you full control on your final video. You will have to choose the format, the quality and resolution, and then on the right the output folder, which is the destination of the video. When your settings are fine, click on Start to get your video. Check out our next video to know the best render settings for YouTube. Thanks for watching this video. Check our full guide for more.